Anna, you will never believe what happened to me yesterday. Oh my God. I was on my date with Fred. Yeah, the guy I told you about? No, not that one. Fred, the football player from Queens. Him. He finally took me out last night and I was so nervous. I mean, this guy is hot. I was a complete airhead over the entire thing. Like, what should I wear? How much makeup should I apply to my face? Should I wear a push-up bra or stuff the bra? Issues. Anyways, we went out and the worst thing in the world happened to me. No, I didn't run into any ex-boyfriends. No, I didn't say something stupid. No, I didn't do something clumsy. Look, worse. You ready? I shit my drawers. I know. Ooh, please, God Almighty. Look, I was there and it happened to me. I was so nervous that when he came to pick me up, I felt bloated. I was so busy getting dressed all day that I did not have enough time to eat. So I didn't have nothing in me but air. I shit my drawers, Anna! We were walking through the park and I had to let out a little bit of air. I had been holding back that far for hours. So I thought it would give me a little bit of relief just to, you know, let out a little poof. But it was no poof, Anna. It was more like a... And then there's that moment. That moment when you know something don't feel right. And you're not sure if it's true. You're not sure if you really just shit your pants or not. And I'm dying on the inside. I'm praying to God like, God? Did I just shot myself? Oh my God. I certainly did, Anna. I sharted all on the inside of my undies. And I was wearing the sexiest thong. And you know, obviously, thongs aren't that shit-known type of fabric. So there I was, walking with the hottest football player from Queens, clenching my butt cheeks until they were turning blue so that cocky wouldn't drip down my leg. This had to be the worst experience of my life. What did I do? I started acting. I didn't even know I had it in me. I started freaking out. I acted like I was petrified of squirrels. I know. I must have sounded like a demented fool, but it was the only thing I could think of. What in the hell would you have said? I started dancing around him, acting like I was petrified of these squirrels, and I made up this whole entire story saying how as a child, I was attacked by squirrels while playing in the woods, and that I had a phobia. He believed me, and do you know what he did? You will never believe what he did. He picked me up off the ground and said that he wanted to be my hero, that he wanted to protect me. And then we locked eyes, but it wasn't in a passionate trance. We locked eyes because we both smelled shit. Oh my God. He said, "Oh, you poor thing. You poor, poor thing. You made a poopy." And it was at that moment that I almost gave up on life. And I said, "You know what? Screw this." I looked at him and said, "Fred, I crapped my pants, okay? I crapped my pants because of those damn squirrels." And that was that. That was my date with the hottest football player from Queens. He called, but it was more of a courtesy call, not a "I want to see you again" type call. I could hear his friends in the background laughing, making fart noises. I mean, what else is there to be said? Next time I get a hot date, I'm gonna make sure I eat like a slob beforehand. Amen to that, girl. Hold on. They have me on the camera.